Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're talking about the law of signs, and we're looking at an ambiguous case that has two solutions. All right, to speed things up, I've already put some of the work together. Here we have angle A. We're taking the sine 42, dividing it by the opposite side length, 52. Angle B, we're taking the sine of B, which we don't know, dividing that by 63. Cross multiply to get this equation here, and then we take the arc sine of both sides to find out that B is approximately 54 degrees. All right, and doing that, now we need to find out if the measure of angle B could potentially have a different value. So we'll call that B sub 2. And we're saying that B sub 2 is equal to 180 minus the measure of angle B that we just found. And we find that that comes out to be 126 as a potential value for B sub 2 for the other triangle. But before we can settle on that measure, we have to do another test. And in this test, we're going to take the 126 degrees. We're going to add it to the 42 degrees that we know of in angle A. And that should actually be less than 180 degrees. If it's greater than 180, then we know that it's not we know it's not a triangle, and we know that we don't have a second solution. And in doing so, when we add these two numbers together or evaluate, we get 168, and we see that it is less than 180, so we know that the measure of 126 degrees is a valid measure for the second possibility for the measure of angle B. So we're going to add the 126 degrees here. All right, let's shift our focus back to our first solution. To find the measure of angle C, we know that the measure of all the angles of a triangle, when you sum them, they add up to 180. So let's do that here. 42 degrees plus 54 degrees plus C, we know should equal 180. When we evaluate, we find out that the measure of angle C is actually 84 degrees. So let's add that to our first triangle. And now we're going to fall back to the law of sines to figure out what the length of side C is. So it takes the sine of 42 degrees, divide that by 52, and we set that equal to the sine of 84 degrees divided by the unknown length of C. When we cross multiply and evaluate, we find out that C comes out to be approximately 77 units. So let's go ahead and add our 77 units to our first triangle. So here we've completed all the measures for our first triangle. Now let's focus our attention on our second solution, or our second triangle. First thing we want to do is find the measure of angle C, and that's easy to do because we know that all three of these measures should add up to 180. So let's go ahead and do that. We have 42 plus 126 plus the measure of C sub 2 should equal 180. When we do all the math and evaluate, we find out that the measure of C sub 2 is 12. So let's add that to our listing. And again, we fall back on the law of sines to find out the length of side C. So again, we take the sine of 42 divided by the length of the opposite side, which is 52. Then we take the sine of 12, and we divide that by the unknown length of C sub 2. When we cross multiply and evaluate, we find out that C sub 2 is approximately 16. So here we've taken an ambiguous case, and we've shown that there are two solutions, and we have all those solutions here in both of these charts. All right, so that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name, Spell Tutorial. Thank you again for watching.